Okay, so good morning all of you. This is Dr. Sanjeev and this is BA2 class at 1040 British Poetry and Drama class. And in this class I am going to discuss the remaining two cantos of the poem Ode to the West Wind that is composed by P.B. Shelley. As we have already discussed the three cantos in which the poet is talking about the dead leaves, the clouds and the waves. So in this fourth canto, what he is going to talk about and what he is going to describe and express or reflect upon, let's discuss. See, it begins with first person pronoun. See, it has, if I were dead leaf, a dead leaf, thou mightest bear. If I were a swift cloud to fly with thee, a wave to pant beneath thy power and share the impulse of thy strength. Only less free than thou, uncontrollable. So see, this is the fourth canto of the poem Ode to the West Wind. And what is there in this fourth canto? Let us see. Now, the poet is reimagining his identity. He is again thinking about whether he is a man or he wants to be a dead leaf. That is why he is saying, he is just imagining as if he were. Kehte na kaash main aisa hota. So poet is saying kaash ki wo dead leaf hota. The structure that is used, if I were, a plural verb with singular subject and especially the past verb, it shows that you are imagining, you are presuming. If it was really only you were, what it is being said, like kaash aisa hota. So you are thinking shayad aisa kuch hota to acha hota. Then this poet is also, yes.
Sir, please share the screen.
It is sharing. Okay, not sharing.
No, sir.
Okay, now is it sharing?
No sir,
नहीं
दिख रहा है.
ओके.
यस सर.
दिख ही नहीं रहा है.
हाँ,
ये चार लाइनें, छह लाइनें लिखी हैं, दिख रहा है.
दिख रहा है सर.
दिख रहा है सर.
दीज आर द थिंग दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट.
यस सर, दिख रहा
है. ओके, सो व्हाट पोएट इज इमेजिनिंग, व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से. He is saying that if he were a leaf, then what could happen with him? He must have been brought away, or he must have been driven away by the force of the west wind, by the might or strength of the west wind. As in the first stanza, you see that the west wind drives away the dead leaves. Or if he were a swift cloud, as you see in the second stanza, he could fly with the west wind, as the west wind scatters all clouds into the sky and takes away with itself. And if he were a wave, what do waves do? When west wind happens or comes, it starts disturbing, it starts taking waves with itself and dashes to the seashore, and it disturbs the whole Mediterranean. So what happens with the Mediterranean when the west wind comes? It starts trembling, it starts shaking, and that is why he says paint, jaise hafna hota hai. So he would be terrified. So now he is comparing himself with the three objects that are mentioned into the first three cantos, and he is imagining if it were possible, and he would be, or if only he were like the dead leaf or the swift cloud or the wave that are described, he could also have the strength of the west wind. Aise, in the same way, jaise ki aap logon ne dekha ki in the three stanzas, the west wind is becoming the force, the power that disturbs, that takes away, that scatters all these mentioned objects. Okay. And he wants to do what? He wants to share the impulse of the strength. It means that poet is trying to negate his personal identity as a human being, and he wants to continue, or he wants to adopt the identity of the three mentioned objects, so that he can share the power of the west wind, the strength of the west wind, the impulse that it has. It has very powerful impulse, it has very strong, you can say, capacity to lead things, and that is why he wants to be sharer into the power of the west wind. And see, on less free, only less free than thou, O uncontrollable. And if he would be able to look at these objects, and he will assume their identity, he will become like leaf, or he will become like cloud, or he will become like the wave, what will become? He will become less free, because these are the objects mentioned, they are controlled by the west wind. And that will happen with him, what? Like the west wind is uncontrollable, the poet will also become uncontrollable. So that is why he is saying, oh, uncontrollable. He is addressing the west wind. The west wind, as in the beginning I said, it is tameless, it cannot be controlled. And if Shelley is trying to become one like that leaf or the cloud or the wave, he will also be uncontrollable. So human identity is, it means, controlled by people, controlled by situations, controlled by everything. And the identity of the west wind is uncontrollable, nobody can control it. So perhaps he is trying to compare the condition of humans with the condition of the west wind and its power. At the same time, he finds that the human condition is controlled, tamed, and it is monitored by things. But the west wind is beyond all kinds of monitoring and control. That is, it is uncontrollable. And only uncontrollable things can help Shelley spread out his ideas. अपने आइडियाज को शैली को स्प्रेड आउट करने के लिए एक ऐसी चीज चाहे दैट कैन नॉट बी कंट्रोल्ड बाय एनीवन. ओके, इफ इवन आई वर एज इन माय बॉयहुड एंड बी क्लाउड, करे काश एज ही वाज, इट मींस दैट द चाइल्डहुड डेज वर हैप्पी डेज एंड चाइल्डहुड डेज वर अनकंट्रोल्ड डेज व्हेन पीपल वर नॉट कंट्रोल्ड बाय सिचुएशंस बाय पीपल. Children do whatever they like, they don't do whatever they don't like. That is why Shelley is again comparing his youth, or the time when he is writing this poem, something around the time of, you can say, 27, 28 years, and the time of childhood days. Wo bachpane ka daur jisme kya tha? He was much like a swift cloud. The clouds move wherever they want and they go into the direction of the wind. The boy Shelley, into his own childhood, he was also like the cloud. He is imagining, काश मैं जैसे बचपने में था वैसा ही होता. ओके, एंड देन वॉट वुड बी हैपन, द कॉमरेड ऑफ दाई वॉन्डरिंग्स ओवर हैवन. एंड देन वॉट कुड ही डू, कॉमरेड मीन्स कंपेनियन. वो कह रहा है कि अगर मैं बचपने में क्लाउड जैसा जितना चंचल था आज होता, तो मैं क्या करता, तुम्हारे साथ वेस्ट विंड के साथ मैं स्वर्ग तक तुम्हारा साथी बन करके चलता. इट मीन्स दैट अ पोएट इज प्रिज्यूमिंग और री इमेजिनिंग, रिफ्लेक्टिंग अपॉन हिज चाइल्डहुड डेज एंड द इनोसेंस एंड चाइल्ड लाइकनेस आउट ऑफ दैट पीरियड, एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू री अडॉप्ट, और ही वॉन्ट्स टू री इंटर इन टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ चाइल्डहुड डेज, सो दैट ही कैन वॉक अवे विद द वेस्ट विंड. And where does west wind go to? West wind goes to heaven. It travels from the ocean, and its origins it has into ocean, and it moves to heaven. Actually, the reality is that west wind does not go to heaven. It is originated on the sea bodies or water bodies, and it ends on the land bodies. But the thing is that he is addressing the west wind to be the most powerful object, and this is an ode. That is why he is appreciating the west wind as a very divine or very powerful medium, very powerful existence. And he is thinking that he could become a companion, a friend, or a comrade, if he were like a cloud, he could move with the west wind to the heaven. And try to understand why clouds can go to heaven, because clouds fly into the sky, they move into the sky. And if he were a cloud, he could go to heaven, because in the sky there is heaven as it is presumed. ऐसा लगता है ना, कहते हैं कि स्वर्ग तो आसमान में है या ऊपर कहीं है. And these are the only clouds that can go with the help of the west wind, because leaves cannot be driven away into the sky, and the water waves cannot also be driven away into the sky, but clouds can be driven away into the sky. So he is saying that if he were a child, he were like cloud, he could be traveling with the west wind to heaven as the companion. Okay, as then when to outstrip thy sky speed, scars seemed a vision. And what he is saying, when he has been outstripped, sab kuch usse chheen liya gaya hai. Because in the childhood days, Shelley was very childlike. Childlike ise kehte bahut chanchal hona. And now when he has become young, all these things have gone from him. Shelley has also written a poem on cloud. Okay, so it is not that reference, but children are very innocent people, very innocent entities, and they have fairies, they have, you can say, divine spark within them. They are quite innocent, quite cute, quite, you can say, pure into their heart and soul. And then they are very, you can say, swift, bahut chanchal hote hain. And because he is not a child anymore, he thinks that those capacities which he had into childhood days, they are stripped away, they are outstripped. उससे सब छीन ली गई हैं. एंड द स्पीड, स्काई स्पीड, जैसे स्काइंग करते हैं ना बर्फ पे. स्काइंग इज अ प्ले, आई मीन यू कैन से अ गेम दैट इज प्लेड ऑन स्नो सरफेस. यू माइट हैव सीन दैट टू पीपल टेक स्टिक्स, और वन पर्सन टेक्स स्टिक्स इन टू हिज बोथ ऑफ हिज हैंड्स, एंड ही हैज अ शू दैट इज मच लाइक अ स्मॉल शिप और याट. And then with the help of that particular two sticks, he moves fastly on the snow surface. So that is the speed that he is talking about, that this speed is gone. And the vision is scarce. Scarce matlab, he is not able to figure out. He is not able to exactly remember the days, the speed, because he has lost everything. Okay, he has not that capacity to visualize the strength that he had into the childhood time. And he also is not able to understand what would happen when he would become a cloud and he will go to heaven with the west wind. See why it is happening. He is saying that his power, his strength to vision things, to understand things, is lessening. It is becoming scarce, kam ho rahi hai. In youth days, it becomes, and when you become mature, you lose your power of creativity, your imaginative power. You become more practical, you become more experienced. The another possible interpretation is that, as I mentioned, this poem is written on the background, that is the Peterloo massacre that happened in something around 1818 and 1819. And three, governments control things. People were protesting peacefully for their rights, but massacres happened and people were frightened. So what is the situation like? He is saying that his vision is becoming scarce, becoming weak. In the same way, when things are quite unfavorable, people also lose their capacity to see the future. Jab aap kabhi buri paristhiti mein hote hain, you don't find any hope and you don't find any way out, you also feel the same, that you have lost things. Okay, you are not able to figure out what is your future. So vision is always about future. I would never have been striving as thus with thee in prayer in my sore need. And he is thinking that he needs the power of the west wind. That is why he is praying. Striving, strive matlab hota hai struggle karna, to make effort to find out. Shelley needs the power, needs the strength of the west wind. and that is why he is praying west wind. Okay. Oh, lift me. And now he is describing his own condition, his own problem, like what he says that, oh, lift me as a wave, a leaf, a cloud. इसीलिए मुझे क्या करो, as you have done, he is addressing the west wind and he is asking the west wind that as west wind has done with the dead leaves, as the west wind has done with clouds and waves, he also wants to be lifted away by the west wind and taking into another world. He wants to be taken into another world by the west wind. Because I fall upon the thorns of life, I bleed. Okay. So this has two interpretations. One, that he is falling upon the thorns of life and he is bleeding. Okay. And the other possible interpretation is that when he is going to die and bleed, only then he can move with the west wind, because west wind can take away only non-living and small creatures. Living creatures, heavy creatures like human beings, they cannot be taken away by the west wind. So he wants to be a dead man. Only after he would be able to fly with the west wind, as his spirits go with the west wind. Okay, so both possible interpretations are there, because Shelley is not so happy and the condition is really very bad. And this is a metaphor. I fall upon the thorns of life. He's saying that he has fallen upon the life that is full of thorns. जैसे आप कहते हैं ना कि camel is the ship of desert. So life is compared as a way, as a road that is full of thorns, or you can say as a bed where people you can say sleep or they fall down, but that bed is of thorns. Okay, so he is saying that
hello,
जब आप लोग अपना शेयर करना स्क्रीन बंद करेंगे तब ना बेटा, आप लोग खुद ही अपनी स्क्रीन शेयर करने लगते हैं. हाँ,
अभिषेक महोदया सर प्रेजेंटेशन चालू कर रखा है,
इसीलिए तो कह रहे हैं. आप अभिषेक अपना प्रेजेंटेशन बंद करिए, अदरवाइज हम आपको रिमूव कर देंगे. स्क्रीन शेयर करना बंद करिए. ओके, नाउ यू आर एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन?
नो सर.
नो सर,
यही सब खराब लगता है ना बेटा. ये अब ओके, आप लोग अभी तक क्लास ज्वाइन करना सीख नहीं पाए. अभिषेक मौर्या कौन है? प्लीज ज्वाइन द क्लास ओनली, डोंट शेयर योर स्क्रीन. डिस्टर्ब हो जाता है, फ्लो खराब हो जाता है बेटा. ओके, सो एनीवे, लेट्स कम बैक टू द पोएम. सो व्हाट ही इज सेइंग दैट द कंडीशन ऑफ लाइफ इज नॉट गुड. You see, whole romantic poet, they describe life as beautiful. They set their poems into the countryside. But what Shelley is saying, that he has fallen upon the thorns of life. So it means that life is not that happier as it is shown into the whole romantic poetry. And he is bleeding. So both possible interpretation. One, that he is in pain. He wants to convey something. That is why he needs the power of the west wind. Or he wants to be the part of the west wind only after getting, you can say, after being dead. So he wants to bleed, he wants to die. Only then he can share the power of the west wind, as in few previous lines he wants to do. Okay, what he is now seeing in the further lines? A heavy weight of ours had chained and bowed, one too like thee. Karaki, he Shelley thinks that he is one like the west wind. Shelley is that powerful person, that revolutionary person. But the problem with Shelley is that the heavy weight of ours, jo samay ka bhar hai, and that weight is so heavy. What does it mean? The moment in which he is leaving, and the moment that is so painful, politically disturbed because of the massacre that has happened. At the same time, he was you can say branded as an atheist, and he was moving from one place to another. And one more reference is there, Shelley at this moment he also lost his first child that was born with Mary Shelley. So there are so many other things that are getting close, are getting collected to intensify the pain that poet is feeling. So that is why he has been bowed down. He has been chained. He does not have any strength to move forward and stay erected, stay straight. But earlier he was also one like the west wind. He was also strong. He was also unchained. He was also free. Okay, so Shelley has been much like swift, tameless and proud, but now the condition is different. But he is now juxtaposing his identity perhaps to the identity of the west wind, or he wants to adopt the identity of the west wind, as west wind is tameless, it is swift and it is proud, because west wind cannot be controlled, it is uncontrollable, it cannot be tamed, so it is tameless. It is swift because it moves from place to place as fast, as quickly as possible, and that is why it is proud. And Shelley wants to be one like that. But see, in this stanza, Shelley is talking about his own personal feelings and what he wants to share with the west wind. Like in the way that that is discussed into the last three stanzas, with the leaves, the cloud and the wave. But Shelley wants to become either one of them, or he directly wants to share strength with the west wind. If not one of them, then one like it. So earlier he says, see, if you look at the poem, you'll find that in the beginning he is saying that he wants to share the strength of the west wind, first three lines, like if I were a dead leaf, if I were a swift cloud, if I were a wave. So what he is saying, agar wo wave aur wo kuch nahi ho sakta, he wants to be one like thee, he is saying ki tumhare jaisa hi main ban jaun, and he wants to become swift, uncontrollable, tameless and proud. So this is what Shelley is saying. Now let us come to the next stanza, that is also again very important.